You look at the numbers. 38 points on a very efficient 11 to 16 from the field, 5 of 8 from downtown. And after that 2-point first quarter, the floodgates just opened up for him.
Playoff career high for Chris. And, you know, you said something earlier, and Mike Budenholzer has touched on this, the relationship between he and Giannis. Come in at the same time, experience losing, experience coaching changes. And Mike Budenholzer has said that those trials and travails have deepened the friendship and the strength and the connection between those two guys.
Great synergy with the longest tenured players on this rough squad. This is Elijah Bryant. The handle for the Bucks. BYU and Elon. Cross-court pass didn't make it. Bryant, an interesting story. Had a chance to visit with him before the game. Manassas with the nice block. And Bryant with the rebound. Elijah Bryant was playing professional basketball in Israel up to a month ago before getting the call from the Bucks and leaving there and joining the squad here. Was playing for the storied Maccabi Tel Aviv. It's the Boston Celtics version of Israeli basketball, the kind of traditional powerhouse over there.
Well, given the circumstance, I'm happy for the young man, his wife, and family that he's out of there. Good timing in a lot of levels.
Yeah. Joyous experience over there, I think players have over the years. Lalo Cabarrot into the paint with the left hand. And the Frenchman with a soft touch. Jose Johnson with the steal. About 2.5 minutes to go. Perry on the drive. Johnson with the rebound. That's going to be a goal tip. Going to sit the rest of this one out. And after our game tonight, Sports Center with Scott Van Pelt. Live post-game reaction analysis with Tim Legler, Adrian Wojnarowski with the latest on Rick Carlisle leaving the Mavericks. Don Nelson Jr. also left yesterday. And what you need to see and hear from the first round of the U.S. Open at Torrey Pines. Here's Thanasis.
Don Nelson was the guy who identified Luka as, in his words, by far the best player in that draft class. Pretty much maybe close to get just as much with what he's doing in his first playoff run.
Quite an interesting Trey Young and DeAndre Ayton, who has already made a conference final, might make it to the conference finals before their draft class teammate, Luka Doncic. Not just us, Brown. 5 seconds to go on the shot clock. Hands it off to Forbes. Forbes with an off-balance three, and back comes Tyler Johnson. I'll say this about Thanasis Antetokounmpo. I love his energy, both on the floor and on the bench for this Milwaukee team. And folks, don't think that he's here exclusively because of the relationship with his brother, okay? He is a professional basketball player that's played at a high level. Not two, tried to put Perry in the hole. Out of bounds, it'll come back the other way, but he's played in the EuroLeague and played big minutes on elite teams over there. There's Justin Jackson, of course. So the Milwaukee Bucks will lead from wire to wire and win it behind Chris Middleton's 38 points. And Thanasis with the steal. A little showtime, but maybe not. Foul before. Doris, let's look ahead. Let's look ahead to game 7. Harden played a lot of minutes tonight.
Yep.
40 minutes. Durant, 40 minutes as well. But Harden, when you look at what he did in Game 5, Game 6 tonight, what are your projections for him and in the bigger picture of Brooklyn and what they might be able to bring in the next one? Because I almost feel like if he doesn't improve health-wise, then they might have hit their ceiling what they can do a little bit.
Right, and I'm just going to go back to the point I kept making throughout this game. 26-4 advantage in fast break points. And in the postseason, when things slow and it's a grind, it is so important to get some easy baskets. And because Brooklyn is forced to play at the tempo they're playing, because you know, James only can go so far, right? And has only so much burst. You see the frustration on both sides. But listen, if it's a possession ball game on the road in Brooklyn, who do you trust more?
That's a great point.
I mean, I'd like my chances if I'm in a possession ball game with Kevin Durant.
Yeah, it'll be him. But game sevens reveal strange things sometimes. Antetokounmpo will play arguably one of the biggest games of his career in a couple of nights. We've seen him from his rookie year to where he is now in his eighth season throw up right in front of us. Thanasis will take the shot clock expiration violation. Seeing him become two-time MVP, become a father, part of this Milwaukee community too. And that's blocked by Bryant. Nice exclamation point at the end of the game. Because Chioza thought he was going to get a free one. That's going to do it. The series is tied at 3-3, and we'll have a game seven on Saturday. Middleton and Antetokounmpo combining for 68 points.